Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Today we're going to revise all the class assessments that we already done. So let's start to see these questions one by one and discuss their answers, how they are and how they are the possible correct one. So the first question here in front of you, what is the symbol that going to represent you here? You can say that the two arrows in this way used to represent, you know very well, this the if this arrow in a chemical equation, especially in chemistry, we use this for a reaction, but it is a complete forward side arrow. It's going to tell you one side reaction. Okay, this from reactants to product, you know very well this thing. But here you have this type of arrow, half here and half here, mean to say forward and reverse. So the options are, yeah, so the options are here, dual side reaction, number B, dual side process, number C, reversible reaction and reversible process. So we didn't discuss about the process. So the word process, wherever, it's not the correct one. Or even the dual side reaction, we can say that is the close one, but the actual word and the main symbol that we use for the reversible reaction. So that is the correct option. Okay. Now, the second thing, number two question in front of you. What when the system A plus B, again reversible, convert or form C plus D, is at equilibrium? Okay, no problem. So here, what it shows you, the forward reaction has stopped. Mean to say, when A plus B react and they give you C and D product, in the first option, it tells you when you get your product, reaction stopped. Number two, both the forward and the reverse reaction have stopped. Neither it's going forward, neither it's going backward. Number C, the reverse reaction has stopped. It will not go back and it's also stopped. You know very well, nothing is happened from all the three above options. So the correct one, neither the forward or nor the reverse reaction stopped. So that is the number D, this one, the correct one. Because at equilibrium position, both reactions are going on. Like the seesaw, you can't say that the seesaw is stopped. It's still in moving, but it's in balance condition, okay? A person like he want to move opposite on an accelerator, you know very well. So it's moving upward, but the accelerator is going downward. Same time, both reactions are going on. Meaning of the word anhydrous. You remember very well, in the first lesson, we discussed this in detail, hydrated, dehydrated, and anhydrous words all. So what it's going to tell you here, with water, without water, with copper, without copper. So you know that not copper, not without copper, or even not with water. So that is the correct one, is without water. Now, number four, a reaction in which liquid freeze, you can say that the freezing point, and its solid form change into liquid at same temperature is called. At the same time and the same temperature, they have both these things in solid form and also in liquid form. What we call this? Dual side reaction? No. Dual side process? No. reversible process, no, what we call that is a reversible reaction, same like here. Okay, like your question number one. Yeah, like here the same option, but maybe I will going to change A, B, C, D here, and E, F, G, H. You should know that the options are not similar. Okay, now after this we move to question number 5. So let's see on this. Let me do a little bit, move it down. Yeah, here we are, number 5. Thank you very much. Walaikum salam wa rahmatullah. The student, they join us online. Welcome, my dear students. The student, they join a little bit late. Don't forget, on Monday, you have quiz from the same lesson and the assessment sheet. Don't forget to learn this completely. Now, number 5. The water melts and freeze at. Before you... Don't forget the upper statement. Number 4, it tells you in another word, water melts and freeze. You know, water in liquid form. Actually, here melting of water means ice. What it means here? Ice. That should be in solid form. And freeze. Different temperature, different pressure, or same pressure. Same temperature. You know very well the melting and boiling point related to temperature. The melting and your smile is very nice, but please don't smile and concentrate here. Same temperature. Okay. Understand, my dear students? Okay. Now, number 6. If you remember in the 3rd or 2nd last lesson, that lecture, we discussed about titration and we learned about phenolphthalein. That is an indicator. What is a phenolphthalein? An indicator. So change color in acid, in water. No, the correct one is alkalis. Okay. So till here, if you have any question, you can raise your hand. Otherwise, type no in the chat. And the students, they join us online. What they need to do, they type their question. Inshallah, I will reply you. Number 7, dye, which change color over a specific pH range is what? So the options are number A, acid-base indicator, reactants, product. So here the correct one is acid-base indicator. Okay, because they change their color due to the medium that is acidic or basic. You know very well about this. Now, next question from, I think, 2nd page, number 8. So let's start to understand this one, the statement. Equilibrium can be attained only from one side. Yes. Understand? Now, the second one, equilibrium of a reaction depends on the concentration of reactant. Only one thing. So that is? Not true. It's false. Very nice. Now let's see to discuss about the question number 10. What is the statement? In which of the following conditions do you think the rate of both forward and backward reactions are the same? First of all, you should know the meaning of rate. I'm very sorry during the recording. I'm going to tell you, Mr. Farid, Ahmad, you are not concentrating. Please, my dear. These questions are not the simple ones. These are IGCSE level questions. Okay. That will help you, inshallah, in the university, in the IGCSE exams. So here you waste your time to discuss and smile and chat. Then in the IGCSE, maybe teacher will smile on you. So I don't want to say these words. Yeah. Because after that, you need to do this. You don't think that we finished here and we get a job and then the education finished. No, you need to go there. That is your very important thing. So I tried to explain you these things in detail. So please, inshallah. So what is the meaning of rate? My dear student, rates mean amount of product or reactants, they may be converted in the given time period. How much product is formed during time? That is name here or mean here rate. For example, you have reactants. They convert into product. It will take 5 minutes. Just example. So you can say that what is the rate of reaction? Mean to say how much time it takes to make or produce product. That is called rate. Understand? Here meaning of rate. So rate of both forward and backward reaction are the same. First, during unstable equilibrium, that is not correct. Not in an equilibrium, wrong. In the beginning of the reaction, no. So the last and the final is during equilibrium. That is the correct one. Now after this, we come to number 11. Dynamic equilibrium mainly concerned about what? When you have a reaction, and you say that we got equilibrium, and now I want to going to take the equilibrium condition. Actually, what happening in it? Spontaneous reaction, it's mean quickly, correct, not correct, wrong, actually. Non-spontaneous, also not the correct option. Irreversible means only go forward. That will not come back. That is the meaning of irreversible. So this is the correct one, reversible reaction. Understand? So like this, it will go forward and it will come back. That is the meaning of irreversible reaction. Understand? So irreversible reaction, not irreversible. That is irreversible and that is reversible. Irreversible means to say the reaction that will happen, the product form, this product will not come back easily. Okay? That is irreversible. And reversible means if you get product and product can give you back again reactants. Okay, my dear? So till here, any question, please raise your hand. Otherwise, type no in the chat. Okay. Almost 8 or 9 questions are remaining. We can done easily. Thank you very much, Marwan, Basil, Abdullah. Welcome, my dear. Welcome. Thanks. Okay. Now, question number 12. It is a very simple statement. Please. Yes, I know you have a lot of knowledge. And after this, you will be out from the class. This, the last 3 students. No, me. Okay, please concentrate here. Come back. Dynamic equilibrium is not like a balancing seesaw. It's true. It's not mean in the balancing seesaw, what are you doing? You are just going to maintain weight, both sides, okay? And when the weight is equal, your seesaw will become a balanced. But during dynamic equilibrium, it will not work like this. So that is the true one. The position of equilibrium of a reversible reaction can be altered. Altered means change, okay? How it going to change? By changing the reaction condition. What are the conditions? You know very well. We discuss concentration, we discussed about temperature, and we also learned about pressure. So these are the conditions. So the x mean the position of reversible reaction can be changed by changing the reaction condition. If you're going to change the temperature, it will change. It will, you're going to change the concentration, it will change. You're going to change the pressure, it will change. So that is the true statement. Okay, welcome, my dear. Welcome, thank you. So next, last page from today's. The position of equilibrium of a reverse reaction can be altered by changing the reaction. We're done. Number 14, the effect of temperature on equilibrium has to do with the dash of reaction. You know very well the effect of temperature. Okay. So temperature change what? Pressure, heat, concentration. So temperature linked with heat. Temperature linked with heat. So the correct option is here, heat. Now, question number 15. No problem. 14? Okay. Yes, please. Okay, the answer I already mentioned here. This is the answer, heat. Now understand? Okay, no problem. If you, even you can type in the chat, I will reply you, don't worry. Okay, maybe I will not type, I will speak. Okay, now please come back and concentrate on number 15. That is the last part. If the volume of a system increase, try to understand. Here we going to discuss about the volume. Mean area, the space where we have the reaction. What it mean? For example, you can see this the area in which the A and B reactants are reacting. What I'm going to do? I increase the volume. I make it big. So it mean I increase the volume. Okay. So what it, the next thing here? Increase or dash decrease. The production of additional moles of gas will be forward. What it means? The pressure. Okay. What will decrease? Pressure will decrease. Again, try to understand this thing. If in the small area, they strike with one another, they collide with themselves, with the wall of the container more. But if we make it big, they have big area. For example, if I let 20 students to play football in this room, in the classroom, they all will strike with one another. They collide again and again. But if I will let you to play in the ground, you can play easily. It means there the collision will decrease due to increase the area or the volume. Understand? Very good. That's clear. Now, strong acids split up, mean to say dissociate, please Mr. Daud, almost completely in water. So you know very well, if the acid is strong, it will going to dissociate completely. The weak acid will not dissociate, it will go back again. And you can say that it's going to show you reversible reaction. So that statement is true. An acid is a substance that donates proton. You know very well about this. Even yesterday we discussed in detail about this. So that donates proton mean to say H positive ion or accept a pair of valence electron to form a bond. This one is also true. So number 19, the second last one, base as a dash acceptor. Base as a proton acceptor. Yeah, yesterday we done this, you remember. So base, you know very well that accept protons or proton acceptor. Acid as a dash donor. Again like this, this statement, acid as a dash donor, acid as a proton donor, not electron, not both. So this one is the correct one. So till here, my dear students, if you want to ask anything, you can. Otherwise, type no in the chat. And please, so please revise these all. I already uploaded this lesson and this worksheet in the LMS. You can find there any question, even from the beginning, from the lesson, you can ask, because we still have almost 5 minutes.